With pads. And with pads. The third one. Return back. No pads. No pads. And the fourth one.
The rule for this is no return type. No return type. So here, the return type should be void. So whenever you say that the function with no return type, that means this function is not returning any value to the calling function. So no return type, we will write this one as void. This is the function name. Function name. Function name. These are the parameters. These are the parameters. So how many parameters are there? No parameters are there. No parameters means zero parameters are there. Zero parameters. Zero parameters. So the function with no return type and no parameters will be like this. Will be like this. Why? Why did you say that this function is not returning any value. This function is not returning any value to the calling function. That is the meaning here. That is the meaning. Now, example. We shall see with an example program. Example program. So, as include stdio.h. Now void. Void. Multiplication. So multiplication. So void means it is not returning anything. Here parameters. How many parameters are there? Zero parameters or no parameter. No parameter. Now int a comma b comma c. A is equal to 5, B is equal to 3, C is equal to A into B. A into B. Printf. C is equal to percentage D, C. C is equal to percentage D, C. Now I am writing the main function. Main function. Int main. Int main. Now, here I am taking one variable, answer. Answer. Answer is equal to multiply function. Answer is equal to, one second. Here I will not take any variable. Just in this, I am calling this function, printf, \n hello. And printf world. Return zero as s. Now so function with no return type and no parameter. So here I am writing one program. The program, this is the multiplication of two numbers. Say that multiplication of two numbers. I am saving this one as multiply. Multiply dot C. Multiply dot C. The program name is multiply dot C. Now, how many functions are there? One is multiplication function. I am naming this one as MUL. open parenthesis and close parenthesis. Another function is main function. Another function is main function. So whenever the program is executed, always the main function is executed first. Main function is always executed first. Now here what I am doing, I am using that printf hello. So this function is displaying some message onto the output screen. So what will be the output? What will the output of this program? So printf hello. It will display a message hello onto the output screen. Hello onto the output screen. What is the next statement? The next statement is multiplication function. Multiplication function. So whenever open and close parenthesis are there, then we call this one as a function ending with a semicolon. Here this is ending with a semicolon. So here ending with a semicolon means this is the main is the calling function. Main is the calling function. Now the compiler will check where this multiplication function code is written. The multiplication function code is written here. So the control will come here. The control will come here to execute the multiplication function. Now how many variables have I declared here? A, B, C. So A is containing 5, B is containing 3. Now I am calculating the value of C. What is C? C is equal to A into B. 5 into 3 is 15. 5 into 3 is 15. Now see here, I am not returning here. I am not writing RETURN because the return type is void. You should not write RETURN. This because this function is having no return type. No return type and no parameter. This is having no return type. No return type means you should not write return 0 or return 1 like that or return C. Here I am writing printf C is equal to A, C. What is the C value? C value is 15. So the C is equal to 15 is displayed onto the output screen. C is displayed onto the output screen. Now this function execution is completed. All the set of statements of this function execution is completed. Now who has called this function? Main has called. The control will return back here. The control will return back here. See here, I have not written C is equal to or sum is equal to like that because this function is not returning anything. That's why I have written here it as a Y. This time calling the function MEL open parenthesis, close parenthesis, semicolon. So after completing the execution of this function, the control will resume here. The control comes here and it will execute the below statement. What is the below statement? The below statement is the displaying the message void. Displaying the message void. So this is the first parameter passing mechanism. First parameter passing. One is without return type, without no return type and no parameter. No return type, no parameter. What is the program? Multiply dot C. Whenever we run the program, always main function is executed first. Main function. If there are two functions are there, if there are 100 functions are there, if there are 105 functions are there, main function is always executed first. So main function, calling the function. Where this function is written? The function code is written here. So this function execution complete. After completing the execution of the set of statements of this function, the control will return back to the main function. Now, next statement is printf world. Return 0, close. Why I am writing return 0? Because the main function return type is integer. Main function return type is integer. That's why I am writing return 0. Return 0, close the main function. Whenever the main function completes execution, then we say that entire program has completed execution. Entire program has completed its execution. By that time, the output will be hello, C is equal to 15, void. Hello, C. In main, we have written MUL, open parenthesis, close parenthesis, semicolon. Then we say that this main is the calling function. Main is the calling function. Which function it is calling? It is calling mul function, multiplication function. So this mul function is the called function. This mul function is called the called function. That is the calling function. In this, having anybody having any doubt? No return type means you have to always write void. No parameters means it should be blank. Zero parameters is called as no parameter. Inside is called as parameter. This is the return type. Return type. Second, no return type means void function name function name. Here parameter 1, parameter 2, etc, comma, etc. Now, this is the set of statements. Set of statement is also called as block. So, no return type. No return type means what? Function name. What does this function is performing? Whether it is performing addition of two numbers, whether it is performing to check the prime number or not, whether it is performing sine series or cosine series, or whether it is performing the pyramid pattern, star, CFC, and the parameter. Because with parameters, parameter 1, parameter 2, etc. Any number of parameters, depending on the requirement of the program. Now we shall see this second type with an example program. This is the rule. This is the rule for no return type. No return type and with parameters. This is the rule. Now we shall see with an example program. Example program. Now, hash include std.io.h. Now, no return type means just I will write void. Void. Now, what I will do is subtraction. Subtraction. Int A, int B. Int A, int B. Because it is containing parameters, so I need to write some variable name. Int A is the variable name, B is the variable name. B is of type integer, A is of type integer. So these are the two parameters. These are the two parameters separated by comma. Separated by comma. Now, inside this I will declare one variable C. Here what I will do is, I will do A minus B because I want to subtract the two values. So I return the function name as subtraction. Subtract. So since it is not returning, I should not return the value. I should not type here RETURN. If you write RETURN, the compiler, when you run the program, the compiler will give us the error because the function is not returning. You have written, you have typed the return statement. So what you have to do is, here only you have to perform the display printf. Printf slash n c is equal to percentage d comma c close the function. So what does this function is performing? This function is performing subtraction function. Subtraction. It is not returning any type. So no return type means you have to write void. All are in small letters only. V is also small. All remaining letters are also small. Small letters. Now here this is the parameter. Parameters are separated by comma. So A is of type integer, B is of type integer. So I am declaring the variable C. What I am performing? A minus B. I am displaying the value of subtraction result is C. Now, this is the program. Say that this is the subtraction program. Subtract.c. I have named this one as subtract.c. Now I have written this function, but compulsory a program must contain main function. So now I will write the main function. Int main printf dvrt subtraction 5, 10 printf college. Printf college. Here, this main function is containing int. Int is the return type. That's why we are writing always return 0. Return 0. Close the main function. Close the main function. So now we say that this is the program. This program subtract.c is containing two functions. One function is sub function. Another function is main function. When we run the program, always main function is executed first. Main function is executed first. So what is the first statement? The first statement is displaying the DVRIT, displaying some message onto the output screen. So what will be the output? The output is DVRIT. What is the second statement? The second statement I am writing as SUB, sub, open parenthesis, close parenthesis, I am passing some value, 5, 10, 5, 10, ending with a semicolon. Now 5, now this is a function. I am writing open parenthesis and close parenthesis, semicolon. This is a function. Now where this function code is written, the function code is written here. So the compiler, the control will come here. The control will come here. What I am passing? I am passing 5, 10.
What is the next statement? Subtraction 5, 10. So whenever I am writing this open and close parenthesis, this is a function. This is a function. So I am passing two values, 5, 10. What is 5? 5 is an integer value. What is 10? 10 is an integer value. The control will come here. The control will come here based on the subtraction function. Since here it is containing two parameters, so I need to pass the two parameters. This is 5. 5 is copied into A and 10 is copied into B. 10 is copied into B. This function executes. Now I have declared this variable C in the index functions. Subtraction C is equal to A plus B. What is 5 minus 10? 5 minus 10 is minus 5. Minus 5 is stored in C. So I have displayed the message, the value C is equal to percentage C. So what will be the output? C is equal to minus 5. C is equal to minus 5. Since the return type is void, I should not write return. That's why I am displaying here itself C is equal to percentage C. Now the function is completed. All the instructions of this set of statements of this function are execution completed. Who has called this function? Main function has called this function. So the control will return back. Return back here. It will continue the below statement. What are the below statements? Print it. Display the message. The message here at that time has copied. For the return 0, close the main function. When the main function completes execution, then we say that the program has completed its execution. The program has completed its execution. Now, by the time the output will be DVRIT C is equal to minus 5, call it. C is equal to minus 5, call it. So,